In today's session, we are going to talk about firefighting system design, the intervention part. But before this, as per the rules, before starting any service, quickly we'll give the information about MEP. Because people have a lot of confusion. In HVAC session also, we did the same. Today, we did the HVAC demo also at 7:30. And today and now we are dealing with the firefighting system designing. So if you talk about firefighting system designing, plumbing system designing, HV system designing, electrical system designing, all are building services. In short, we used to call MEP services. So if you're learning firefighting system, plumbing system or HVAC or electrical, etc., means you are dealing with the MEP services or building services. So don't confuse. Building services, nothing but MEP services, and if you expand that, you'll find the services. So quickly I'll give you the idea on screen before starting this firefighting. A quick information about the MEP. So you know M stands for what? Mechanical. You see MEP. M is a mechanical, E is electrical, and P is a plumbing. These are all building services. And in under mechanical, you will find HVAC and the firefighting service. And E is an electrical service. Under electrical, you will find lighting load, power load, etc. And P belongs to plumbing. But basically, plumbing refers to domestic cold water, hot water and drainage system as a building service. But don't think that plumbing is only the cold water, hot water and drainage. If you talk about HVAC, in HVAC also we are dealing with the chill water system, chill water piping. That chill water piping also comes under plumbing. In firefighting also we are dealing with the sprinkler piping, this hose reel pipes, we are dealing with the piping. So this firefighting pipes also comes under plumbing. Okay, plumbing as a separate service, that is a building service. In that you'll find domestic hot water, cold water, drainage system, etc. But in general, in a circuit of pipe dealing with the water, we can consider as plumbing. So you'll find plumbing, a part of plumbing in HVAC and other services also. Okay, and altogether these four services, in short, we can call MEP. So in today's session, we are dealing with what? Firefighting. And the firefighting will take care by whom? Mechanical engineer. Basically, this firefighting, this HVAC, even plumbing also deal with the mechanical engineer. And E will take care by electrical engineer. But all the services is designed and installed for what? For one building. So without coordination, it is difficult to deal with any service. So as a mechanical, you are supposed to deal with the HVAC, plumbing and firefighting. And as electrical, you are dealing with electrical service. But you cannot say that I belongs to mechanical, I'll take care only for mechanical services, I'll not link or I'll not coordinate with the electrical. No. Similarly, electrical people also must coordinate with the mechanical services. So coordination is required between these services, means between mechanical and electrical, and all these engineers like mechanical, electrical will coordinate with whom? Civil, because this all services belongs to what? Building. Okay, so if you are dealing with the firefighting, means you are dealing with the part of MEP. Okay, so I think you got the idea. Anyhow, quickly I'll show you one image, because visual learning is more effective. Especially for beginners, those who are dealing with this service first, those who are working, they know about their services. Just for beginners, this image will help you to get the idea about the services. You see this picture in this online, can you able to see the picture with the date 2006? You can say yes or else you can click on the screen, those are using TeamViewer. Yeah, so here you see in this image, you can find electrical cable trace, means electrical service. You can find the HVAC duct. This box, this metal box is called ducts, belongs to HV service. You'll find this pipe belongs to HV chill water pipe. And here is the plumbing drainage pipe. And left side you'll find pipes belongs to firefighting. You see all the services install in one building, and below this pipe level you'll find the level of false ceiling, like thermocol ceiling or metal plain false ceiling, whatever. Means as a mechanical or electrical, you are supposed to design these services above the false ceiling within the limited clearance. So without coordination is difficult. So as electrical, you must coordinate with the other services. As a mechanical, you must coordinate with the electrical services, and all must coordinate as per the building requirement. So without coordination is difficult to deal with any service. So that's the reason in market, in short, we used to call MEP services or building services. Okay. But in today's session, we'll talk about the firefighting system. So let me start with a small presentation. But before this, I'll give you very basic for firefighting. So you can start writing online in classroom. First of all, the course title, the training title. You can start writing online in class. Because if you're learning something, you must know what you are going to learn. You should have the clear idea about the syllabus, about the course title. Means you must go for the mindset first. So if you know what you are going to learn, then you can learn and you can understand, and you can understand the sequence. Okay, so I'll start with the course title, and you can find the syllabus on in our website also, the same syllabus. Okay, I'll show you directly on the updated on the website. So you can log in to our website, that is smtmep.com. And you can find out the classroom training or online training, the syllabus is same, and find out this firefighting system is running. So you see, this training includes allied fire software, which is very useful and in demand in market. And this allied fire software is especially for hydraulic calculation. What is hydraulic calculation, we'll discuss. And in this training program, you'll find this projects, villa project, factory project, and office project. And these are the special features you can go through once. And here you can find out the syllabus. So you can start first with the course title. So in this training, we'll cover firefighting system designing, not fire and safety. Because people have confusion also in my market. Both are different. Fire and safety is for not for only mechanical. Fire and safety can be done by electrical people, can done by any other engineer, or even by can be done by BSc or BCom people also. It's a general course related to safety, and after completing fire and safety course, you'll get the post safety as a safety engineer, HSC, health and safety engineer. But as a mechanical dealing with the services, we are not dealing with the fire and safety, we are dealing with firefighting system design. So don't confuse. We have a separate training for HSC, for safety engineer. Okay, that safety is different. But as a mechanical, we are dealing with MEP, and when we talk about the fire system, firefighting means in MEP means we are talking about firefighting system design. Okay, as the building service. Okay, so don't confuse with this. So we are dealing with the system designing. So in today's session, I'll give you the idea, or I'll give you the overview of the different systems with one presentation with the images to get the idea. Because if you know the basic about the different system, then we can start designing the different systems. Okay, so you can start writing the course title, firefighting system designing. The course title is firefighting system designing. Drafting. And remember, drafting means we are not offering AutoCAD in this firefighting. We are offering directly firefighting drafting. If you don't know AutoCAD, you must learn AutoCAD as a separate course. Okay. But we are offering firefighting drafting in this. So if anyone don't know AutoCAD 2D, they must learn parallelly AutoCAD 2D also. And those who are learning HVAC, in the HVAC, we are offering AutoCAD also before starting with the, before dealing with the HVAC drafting. So generally, maximum majority of people first learn HVAC as a mechanical, or electrical as a electrical. So we already added this AutoCAD 2D in HVAC course as well as in electrical course, and that is also one reason we are not offering this AutoCAD in plumbing and firefighting training. But we are offering drafting for plumbing and firefighting in this training. And myself, SM Ali, and I'll take care for the firefighting training. And for plumbing, one more faculty, Mr. Habib, will take care. Okay. And after completing this firefighting, he will start this plumbing design. And in that plumbing design also, you'll find the drafting, but not AutoCAD. So you'll find this firefighting system designing, comma, drafting, comma, estimation, and installation. So here, first we'll talk about the standard societies. And you know this, if you know any one service, you know about the societies. Like if you know HVAC, you are following ASHRAE. If you are dealing with electrical, we are following NEMA or IES, etc. Because we are living in what modern world, and without using this course in standard, and you know plumbing, already complete plumbing, so you know IPC. So without you following the standard course in standard from the standard society, your design will not accept, because we are living in modern world and we have the ready-made information in the form of course in standard, and that will follow to get the approval of our design. So similarly, like other services, for firefighting, we have a standard society called NFPA. You can make a note online in class. NFPA, I'll write on screen. Yes, here NFPA, you can write the abbreviation, National Fire Protection Association. If you talk about NFPA, NFPA is a society, it belongs to US, and they are dealing with research and development for this firefighting system. But remember, this NFPA is not only involved in building safety. They involve in safety for other areas also, like aircraft, like marine, like industrial, etc. But here we are dealing with the firefighting system designing for what? For building, for building safety. So we'll cover the modules which belongs to the building, because NFPA offering number of modules, hundreds of modules for different areas. So we cannot learn all this, and it's not required, because we are dealing with this firefighting system designing for building. So we have some modules related to the building safety. So what are those modules? Anyhow, you'll find in the notes. I'll give you the idea. For example, NFPA 10. NFPA 10 is for portable fire extinguisher. And you see, in today's session we are dealing with only induction part. The actual training I'll start tomorrow, and we'll follow the notes. In the notes you'll find all the modules. Just I'll give you the idea today. Like NFPA 10 is for portable fire extinguisher. Similarly, NFPA 13, I think you know most of the people, is very important. This for sprinkler system designing. Similarly, NFPA 13 is for sprinkler system designing, and 14 is for standpipe system. Similarly, we have NFPA 70, NFPA 92A, NFPA 101 life safety course, etc. Okay, so the list of modules for building safety is already given in the notes, and that we'll cover in the next session. At present, I'm giving the introduction. Yes. So the modules related to the building will cover in the syllabus. Don't worry. I think you got the idea about NFPA. Similarly, we have other societies also, like FSAI or UL, IBC. So that also we'll discuss in this presentation. So what I'm trying to explain is, when we are dealing with the service, we are following the course and standard. Especially for plumbing and firefighting, we are following the course and standard. Because remember, one important point related to plumbing and firefighting, for both plumbing and firefighting system design is based on the probability, not based on the peak. If you know HVAC or if you know electrical, you can relate this point. For example, if you are dealing with the HVAC, one chiller connect with the multiple AHUs, and when we design the HVAC system, we'll design that system to cover all the AHU at a time. It's peak design. But in case of plumbing or firefighting, we are designing based on the probability. Why? Because, for example, if you talk about this firefighting, suppose consider a building with 10 floors. So what do you think? At a time, all the 10 floors will catch the fire? No. The fire starts from one point, and it will spread. And remember, the system what we are going to design for firefighting, for building safety, is only to control the fire till the fire brigade arrive on site. and no system will give you the 100% guarantee to control the fire. But in actual practice, we have many cases sprinkler system control the fire before arriving the fire brigade. But we are designing and installing these systems for building safety only to control the fire till the fire brigade arrive on site. After that, you'll find the other systems like standpipe one, this hose reel jet options, etc. So that's the reason we are designing this system based on the probability, because at a time the fire will not cast to all the floors. For example, each floor, suppose you'll find say 100 sprinklers and it's a 10 floor building, so total 1000 sprinklers. So we are not designing the pump to supply the water at a time to cover all 1000 sprinklers, because there is no chances. So we'll design based on the probability, and that's the reason we'll follow the codes, we'll follow the standards, and we'll follow the standard societies, because based on the research and development, based on the probability, we have the course and standard, and that will follow at the time of design. Okay, so I think you got the importance of using the standard society, and we'll also learn how to follow the course and standard for an NFPA with the different modules as per the respective topics. It is possible, but it's not required. For example, at a time if you want to supply the water for 1000 sprinkler, the pump capacity is going to be very high and it's not available in market also, and it's not required also. Okay, so we have some conditions based on the probability, based on the course standard, that conditions that course will learn. And especially in firefighting, you must know the course, you must know the sections. So we'll work on that, and I'll provide you this NFP modules also for your reference. For example, when we deal with the NFP 13, I'll provide you the NFP 13 module PDF. And in the class, you'll get the notes. We'll deal with the calculation. But each module is offering almost 300 pages, so that can be used for reference. Okay, so I'll provide you all the modules, don't worry. So with this information, let me open one small presentation to get the idea about firefighting systems. Okay, yes, online, anything to discuss? Any doubts?
No, sir, it's clear for me.
Fine. So I'm going to open one small presentation just to give the brief idea about the systems with some images. So especially for beginners, you can get some idea about the different systems. Presentation, so you can able to read the standard society. So already we talk about NFPA, National Fire Protection Association. Similarly, we have other codes like IFC, International Fire Codes. Next, IBC. Remember, IBC is very useful. With IBC, we can find out the applicable system. So IBC is not only for firefighting. So in IBC, we'll use only Chapter 3 and Chapter 9 for firefighting. In Chapter 3, you are going to learn what are the different types of building. And in Chapter 9, you are going to learn what are the recommended system as per the type of the building. So this IBC is not for the design course. This is to select the type of system as per the type of building. So this is also very useful. In initial stage, we'll use this IBC. Similarly, if you're working in India, we have FSAI, Fire and Security Association of India. But you see, above all is NFPA. Maximum, you see, every country, every city have their own local course. But maximum local course is derived from NFPA, because the International Access Society, accepted society is NFPA. Okay. And if you talk about the material, we'll use UL, under IT laboratory. For example, I think you know ASTM. American Society of Testing Materials. So when you use a material for ducting, piping, for other services, etc., this ASTM will take care for metal specification, metal standard, etc. Similarly, for safety side, this UL will come into picture. If the metal is UL listed, means that metal is safe for the particular operation with respect to the fire. Okay. So this also society. And next we have FM Global, it's an insurance company. For example, if you want to take the insurance of your building from this FM people, you need to follow the codes from this FM Global. Okay, so these are some societies. Next, so directly I'll jump to firefighting systems. You'll find the list here. You see types of fire protection system. Just to get the idea in this at this level, because we are dealing with just the introduction part today. So you can read on screen. First is a fire extinguisher. It's a system. System means it's a very small one. It's a portable type. And next we have automated sprinkler system. In the entire syllabus, this is important and lengthy topic, automated sprinkler system. Because in automated sprinkler system, we have hydraulic calculation, manual hydraulic calculation, and again hydraulic calculation using Alive software, which is very popular and useful in market for especially for approvals. And if you talk about the services, if you compare this firefighting service with the other services, this firefighting system required approval from the municipal or civil defense or the local authority compared with other services. Okay, so for approval also this allied fire software will help, because maximum civil defense or the municipal accept the report from allied fire software. Okay, so this topic is lengthy and important in this entire course. Next we'll talk about the foam system or foam sprinkler system. Then we have water spray. Just I'm reading at this level. If you're not getting anything, don't worry, just let me read this and I'll show you some images to get the idea. Then in the next class, first we'll start with the fire extinguisher, the NFP 10. Okay, so in automated sprinkler system also you'll find the different options like wet, dry, delete system, pre-action system. In detail we'll discuss when we deal with NFP 13. Next we have foam system, then water spray, then CO2 sprinkler system, then clean agent. Most commonly clean agent means FM 200. We have other option like this Energen, no voice, different option, but the chemical is different, the refrigerant is different, but most commonly in market clean agent means FM 200, fire monitoring 200. So it's a commercial name. You will use some special this fluids, nothing but the refrigerant, and this is waterless system. Similarly we have dry, wet, chemical, powder system, wet riser, dry riser, hydrant, etc. Just I'm reading and I'll show you some images to get the idea. So the first image is for portable fire extinguisher. I think you know in hospital schools you can find out this is a manual type. Next we have sprinkler system, automated sprinkler system. I'll give you the idea for this. In this automated sprinkler system, here the different components, you'll find the tank, and next pump sets, and this main pump, this main pipe is called header, and this vertical pipe is called riser, and this horizontal pipe, for example, consider this as a ground floor, this as first floor, and again this pipe will continue to the other floors. Okay, so this horizontal pipe which is entering the floor we can call cross main. Don't worry, I'll cover in detail. Just I'm giving the idea when we start this topic, because this is one of the major important. And the pipe which is connected to the cross main is called branches, and to the branches sprinklers are attached. I think most of the people know what is sprinkler. So sprinkler is a device, automatically it will activate and supply the water on that affected area. Anyhow, we have a topic for sprinklers also. So at this level, in this image, this black dot is a sprinkler. Okay, so how this system activate and why we are calling this automatic sprinkler system. For example, fire occurs somewhere here. Okay, so what happened, the heat will increase in this area. So whenever the heat increase and reaches to say 65 to 70 degree Fahrenheit, the standard for red or orange color sprinkler. We have different thermal rating sprinkler also. At this level I'm just taking the common, the default 65 to 70. So whenever the temperature reaches to 65 to 70 in between, the sprinkler bulb will break. How it will break, I'll show you, don't worry. The sprinkler bulb will break, and inside this pipe completely, this pipe, this circuit completely filled with the water and connected with the pressure switch or pneumatic system. So what will happen, whenever the sprinkler breaks, supply of water, and whenever supply of water, there is a pressure difference in the line, and when the pressure difference means the pressure switch, the sense or the pneumatic system sense there is a pressure difference and automatically activate it, open this valves and open this the switch on this pump, then pump will suck the water from the tank and supply on the affected area. This concept, okay, in detail we'll discuss, don't worry. So that's the reason we are calling this as automated sprinkler, because automatically this happen, there is no manual operation. So we used to call automated sprinkler system. But the more about this we'll discuss, don't worry. Just today I'm just giving the idea about the systems. Next, you see foam system. Instead of water, we are mixing with some chemical and get the foam. And this is generally for generator room or for special cases. Next, water spray. This is also for special case, and at a time completely it will cover with the water. Sprinkler means where sprinkler break, that area only will get the water. But here in water spray system, you see at a time supply of water. This is for higher hazards. Okay. Next, CO2 sprinkler system. You see, this cylinder is filled with the compressed CO2, means carbon dioxide. Bicarbon dioxide also we'll discuss, don't worry. Because carbon dioxide also used to control the fire. And this is used to reduce the oxygen from the fire, as if you talk about as per the concept. So next, clean agent FM200. We are using a refrigerant, and this is very effective. Within 10 seconds we can control the fire, and this FM200 clean agent system is only for refrigerant gas. We are using refrigerant gas in detail. So we are using this refrigerant gas to control the fire within 10 seconds. It's very effective, and this is only for special areas like server rooms, record rooms, etc. Not in all the areas, because this system is expensive. And why we are calling this system as clean agent system? Because after controlling the fire, means for example, if I use water sprinkler system in the server room, so what will happen? The water will help to control the fire, but it will damage, yes, it will damage the server. And you know the importance of server in any company, or similarly record room or cache room, the water will damage. So we are using waterless system, means clean agent. So we are calling clean agent because after controlling the fire, means it will control the fire without disturbing anything in the space. Even if you use a glass of water here on the table, you can drink that water, it will not affect that. So that's the reason we used to call this system as clean agent, or also known as waterless system. Okay. Next, dry or wet chemical powder for kitchen hoods or for kitchen areas. For special type, we are using this powder system. But powder means, you see, it is difficult to spray the powder. So it is mixed with the nitrogen or any other gas to get in a spray form. So this system is a powder system on steam. Next, dry riser. In short, riser means the vertical pipe, for example. And why we used to call dry riser? Because you see, this system is called standpipe class 1, under this standpipe class 1, or we can also call as internal landing valves. So this pipe inside the building, and you see this pipe connected with this special valve called landing valve. So when the fire brigade arrive on site, they will connect the hose pipe to this and they will control the fire. Till the time there is no use of this system. And you see, the end of this pipe is outside the building, on the wall or outside the wall, in the form of a breaching inlet, also known as CMIAS connection or fire brigade connection. So what will happen when the fire brigade with the tanker, when they arrive on site, they will connect one pipe to the tanker, another pipe in the breaching inlet, so that the water can supply to this pipe. Till the time the pipe is empty. So that's the reason we are calling this as dry riser. Okay, but more about this we'll discuss, don't worry. Similarly, we have wet riser. So wet riser means permanently connected with the pump, and pump will suck the water from the tank, and this is permanently charged. So all the time water is present in this. So this is called wet riser system. And this system can be sprinkler system, this system can be hose system, etc. Hydrant system, I'll show you the image, you'll get the idea. Generally outside the building you'll find this valve. Okay. And this hydrant is used to cover the fire from outside the building. Again, this will take care by the trained firefighters, not by the building occupants. So they will connect the hose pipe here, and with the nozzle, they will open the valve with the nozzle. They can control the fire from outside the building. So we can call this as a hydrant, NFPA 24 for this. Similarly, we have fire protection equipments. In the system, you'll find number of equipments. So you'll find the equipment list here. First is a sprinkler, then hose, fire hose, then fire hose reel, then fire hose reel cabinets, etc. In the next slide, I'll show you the images of this equipment to get the idea. At the time of learning the different system, you are going to learn all this equipment, don't worry. This session is just to get the idea about this systems and equipment, especially for beginners. So here on screen, you see, you can find one sprinkler. This is one type of sprinkler. We have different type of sprinkler. The default, this is called pendant. We have upright, we have sidewall. Again, in pendant also we have different types. We'll discuss more about this sprinkler. At this level, this device is a sprinkler, and you can find out the bulb here. Inside you'll find the liquid, which will expand as per the thermal rating. And remember, orange or red color thermal rating is 65 to 70 degrees centigrade, most commonly used for building safety. Next, you see different types of sprinklers. We'll discuss this different type of sprinkler in NFPA 13 after NFPA 10. Next, fire hose reel, hose with the nozzle. First, you see these are hose pipes and canvas type, and this is connected to the standpipe system. So this is a canvas type. One end will connect to the valve, which is called landing valve, special valve we are using in firefighting. The other end will connect to the nozzle, so that we can get the high velocity pressure to control the fire. So this is a canvas type pipe. Similarly, you'll find the rubber type also, fire hose reel. You see, this is a rubber type pipe, and this red colored reel is a hose reel, and this is hose pipe, and end with the nozzle. It's not clearly visible, but you can understand. This is a nozzle here, and one end connected with the valve, and this is hose pipe, rubber type. It can be canvas type also, and this red color is a hose reel. And if I use this complete hose reel in a box, we can call hose reel cabinet. In the next, you'll find. You see, this is a hose reel cabinet. Okay, in market we have other option also called hose rack. Hose reel means it's a roll, but here hose rack means it's a folding. And hose rack means you'll find only with a canvas pipe, not with the rubber pipe. With the rubber pipe we cannot fold, and this is easy to operate in case of fire, easy to pull out. Okay, next we have alarm check valve. So this valve is very important in case of fire. Whenever pressure difference, this valve will open and the pressure, as per the pressure change, and activate the system, activate the alarm, will switch on the valves and other devices, etc. Next, alarms. It can be mechanical type, it can be electronic type, it can be sound plus visual or only sound, different types. Next, pressure switch is also important. Fire hydrants, landing valves, different types of valve. This is a stand post type hydrant. We have a wall type also. And with the two options here, we can open the valve, we can connect the hose pipe and control the fire from outside, again by the trained firefighters only. This fire hydrant, concealed type fire hydrant, like a manual cover. With the cover, you'll find the concealed type, just as per the requirement. Next, landing valve. You'll find landing valve in sprinkler system, in hose reel system, etc. So this is one way landing valve. Similarly, you'll find two way landing valve also. Okay, next we have breaching inlet, nothing but fire brigade connection or CMS connection. You see, when the fire brigade arrive on site, one end of pipe connect to the tank, means the tanker. The other end is connected to this breaching inlet or fire brigade connection, so that when they open the valve, the water can supply to the building. Okay, to the building inside, you know, dry riser, what we discussed, dry riser. Next, firefighting pumps. You find the pump room with all fittings and accessories. And I think, you know, if you talk about the firefighting equipment, firefighting devices on site, it is coated with which color? Red color. Red color is standard for firefighting. On site, you find the pump related to this firefighting or other devices for this firefighting system. You'll find even the pipes also with the red color. Okay, and this pump with all accessories. So we have a separate topic for pump selection. And after pump selection, we have separate topics for pump details. In that, we'll discuss about these accessories, fittings, etc. And we have different types of pump also, like horizontal split case pump, vertical pump, different types of pump. We have a topic. Next, fire blanket. For a small project like a villa, etc., we can use this fire blanket. You see, in case of fire, we can use this fire blanket. It can be mounted on the wall. Next, water tanks. It can be underground tank or it can be tank on the ground level. Mostly underground tanks. Next, fire detection equipments. If you talk about firefighting system, the firefighting system is classified into three categories. You can make a note online in class. Firefighting system classification. Point number one, fire suppression system. Point number two, fire detection system. Then point three, fire indication system. Means all the system is divided into three categories. If you talk about fire suppression system, means the system which is used to control the fire. Like this portable fire extinguisher, which is used to control the fire. Sprinkler system, which is used to control the fire. Hose reel system, also used to control the fire. So all the system comes under fire suppression. Okay, example. Okay, similarly, if you talk about fire detection system, detection means it is used only to detect. You can find on screen, like, you know, smoke detector, heat detectors, addressable systems, etc., which is used to detect the fire only. It is not used to control the fire. Okay, so fire suppression, I think you got the idea. Similarly, fire detection, which is used only to detect. One more, fire indication. Indication means the best example is alarm. Alarm system is used to indicate that fire, na, so that the people can come out from the building. Like this, we have some addressable system which is used to address the fire so that the people can come out from the building and take the necessary action. So all this firefighting system is classified into three categories. And the major and lengthy is what? Fire suppression. In that, sprinkler system is important. So these are the different options. So you can find on screen a smoke detector. You can also find on screen the heat detector. Okay, so this is just an introduction for this system and equipments with some basics. So end of today's session.